Welcome back to our second segment of Nite Line. I'm your host, Sean Hamilton, filling in tonight for Dante, who keep him in your prayers. Always pray for Dante and pray for the TV station. God is doing remarkable things here, like he has been doing for so many years through this network. And we just thank you so much. And I thank him for the opportunity to be able to be here and talk about what I love talking about more than anything else, and that's Jesus Christ. I could talk about Jesus all day because I know what he done for me. That's how you say it in the South. I know what he done for me. I know he changed my life. If it had not been for him, there's no telling where I would be. We want to thank you guys for tuning in to the second segment. We had our first segment with Deborah Lassiter, and we're having this segment with Chainah. Chainah Street. I got it. I finally got it. Let me read this verse of scripture, and then we will get right into talking to you in the ministry, okay? Our verse of scripture tonight is taken from 1 Kings 19. Verse 11 through 12, and it says, and he said, go forth and stand upon the mount before the Lord. And behold, the Lord passed by, and a great and a strong wind rent the mountains and break into pieces, and the rocks fell before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, a small, still voice. And that's where God is. That's where he was at that time. You can find God in a small, still voice. It doesn't always have to be something extraordinary or something that he does that just shakes the ground. God can speak to you in your ear to where only you can hear, and that word that he speaks will be a word that will change your life. So let's spend some time right now talking to Chainah Street. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing real good. I'm glad
That's
to
awesome.
Have you out tonight.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, really good to have you out. Anointed Expressions.
Yes.
Tell me about Anointed Expressions.
Anointed Expressions is a mime ministry formed under Beulah Christian Fellowship, mm-hmm. where the pastor is Pastor James Nesbitt and First Lady Nesbitt.
Okay.
We are located in Mauldin, South Carolina, mm-hmm. where you have the address 1070 Mauldin Road. However, we're proceeding in our phase two of where God is taking us and mm-hmm. As far as our ministry. So we only would be at this location one more Sunday, and then God is going to be blessing us to move into a
beautiful,
different position.
Beautiful,
yes.
Beautiful. Well, that sounds good. So, what did you say your pastor's name was again?
Pastor James Nesbitt.
James Nesbitt. That's
yes.
great. Anointed Expressions, how do you guys impact the community? What do you guys do? You just work there, do your ministry there at the church? I know you're here this evening, but
right.
you know, where do you guys go?
Well, we also we fellowship with other ministries who allow us and invite us to come mm-hmm. minister at their churches as well. But we also, you know, hold certain youth programs that would do give backs to the community as far mm-hmm. as like back to school supplies as well.
Okay. All right. And you do those in different locations?
We host them at Beulah Christian Fellowship.
Okay, beautiful. That's good.
Yes.
So you guys got a pretty good look group of young ladies over there. They
yes.
are smiling. They are they are smiling and having an awesome time in here tonight.
Yes.
Earlier we were talking, and they understand. I asked them a question. I said, you know, who are you doing this for? And they said, we're doing this for the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I know that's not something that kids just normally say.
Right.
And I think the leadership that
right.
they have
mm-hmm.
That instills those things in them.
Right.
To know that what they're doing is just not something to have fun. They want them to have fun.
Right.
But not just for the sole purpose of having fun or being seen.
Right.
It's a ministry.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And how well do they understand that?
I always make it clear to them we don't use the word perform. We don't
mm-hmm.
go out to perform for people. We don't go out to perform for different ministries. We go out to minister. Anytime that we are moving in song or dancing in song, we're ministering to people
mm-hmm.
to let them know we don't always got to shout and scream. Everybody praises God in a different way.
That's right.
And mime is another form of expression that we can have a relationship with God.
Okay. So you have other are there more than just the three ladies?
These three are my faithful three. They are every determined, motivated, faithful mm-hmm. to the cause. They love mime. I think I came to Beulah Christian Fellowship and mimed one time, and it was over for that.
Mm-hmm.
They were just so on board, and ever since then, every Saturday, every time there's a rehearsal, they are there.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm very transparent with them. You know, everyone, we go through different things in life as a survivor of sexual assault and domestic abuse.
Mm-hmm.
I always bring, you know, the victory back. The glory is all God's, and I let them know that. I don't shelter it from them.
Mm-hmm.
So I make it really clear where God has brought me from, and it could do the same for him.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Thank you.
So these ladies, these young ladies, they are in a position to where they can learn
yes.
what to do as being a young lady.
Yes.
Is it all ladies, all young ladies?
So far, we started off, okay. We have a few guys that intermittently come in between, mm-hmm. but right now these three are the sole...
Yeah.
Foundation of Anointed Expressions.
So, I mean, so how exciting is that, that God would choose to use you to be somebody that would pour into the lives of these young ladies? I mean...
I'm very grateful. It started, you know, this year, towards the end of last year, where I started realizing his purpose on mm-hmm. my life. You know, we get so selfish in our pain and what we go through when we don't step outside and say, I went through this because God has someone else that I have to help.
Mm-hmm.
There's another group of people and somebody else that's their blood is on my hands.
Yeah.
So I can't be selfish and say, why me? But be thankful that he chose me because yeah. he could have chose anybody else.
That's right. I was talking earlier to someone and we were quoting from the scripture, 2 Corinthians chapter 1,
right.
where it speaks about, you know, may the God of all comfort
mm-hmm.
comfort you. The mm-hmm. same comfort that you are comforted with,
right.
that ye may be able to comfort those who right. need the comforting.
Right.
You know, and so what God does is he brings us through things and he transforms us.
Yes.
And that transformation, people see
mm-hmm.
that transformation. Because I know a lot of times I run across people that I used to know. Sometimes I had to reintroduce myself.
Right.
You know, because folks are like, man, I didn't even know that was you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, it's me, but I'm a transformed person.
Absolutely.
You know? And to be able to pour back into the lives of young ladies to teach them about mistakes that you've made.
Right.
You know, being transparent, like you mm-hmm. said. To be able to do that, I see that God may bless this on a bigger scale to, you know, mm-hmm. where, you know, the ministry of miming and also the ministry of pouring into the lives of young ladies.
Right.
Yeah. So let me ask you, is this mime ministry open to the community?
Absolutely. We want to open it up to people of all ages, youth, mm-hmm. you know, millennials, the adults. We lose sight of, you know, some people that's not in the church all the way, and they mm-hmm. just, they see what they see on TV, and they think it's just, you know, preaching and shouting. And me growing up, I grew up with, you know, you don't really speak, and it's, you know, speak unless spoken to.
Mm-hmm.
And growing up, I had taken that as a child. I brought that not only in my personal relationships and friendships, but within my relationship with God.
Mm-hmm.
So I got into the mom ministry because I started expressing myself in way of action mm-hmm. and not verbally.
Yeah, you don't even have to speak in mom.
You don't have to speak. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the people in the community, is more so the youth, they don't know how to express themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't know how to verbally have that communication. And a mom is just another way to still have a relationship with God. You can still go to church and have fun and still be saved.
Yeah, that's really good.
Thank you.
You have music in the church. There's preaching and teaching, and
mm-hmm.
you know, you have the greeters and ushers, and you know, there's the elders and deacons and all
right.
those things that go on in the church where, you know, but sometimes the youth, they can feel disconnected,
right?
Because they don't feel like it's something that belongs to them,
right?
But to be able to take that and express it, it's got to be a great thing, right?
If it's great. I love it when the girls can come in and they say, Shay, can I ask you about this?
Mm-hmm.
And talk to me about this? And can we do this on Sunday? It brings excitement to me because I know that they're interested. When you show interest in the youth and you let them know that there's a place for them,
mm-hmm.
they will show the same interest in you.
Okay. So how long have you been doing this now?
Well, I've been miming since I was about 14 years old. I started in Jersey. I used to go to church by myself at times, and I started doing the mime. And like I said, I felt disconnected. I didn't have a relationship the way everybody else had a relationship. And that was my way of, you know, teaching the girls, you don't have to do and praise the way everybody prays. Mm-hmm. So mime was just that another form where I can feel connected and my relationship with God. Mm-hmm. So I've been doing this for a long time.
Okay. And you've had this opportunity just in Jersey and then back here. When did you come here and begin?
I came to South Carolina in about 2013, and I've joined Beulah Christian Fellowship 2015. Mm-hmm. And I've been there faithful. It was my first church I went to down there, and it was the one I've been planted in ever since. They're so loving. It's just that family environment that takes you in. And I ministered in mime one Sunday with a friend, and she asked me, she said, just come on, you can do it. It's like, I haven't done this in years. Mm-hmm. And we performed, and we ministered, and since then, I just couldn't stop.
Okay, so you still?
I still mime. I get in right with the girls. Okay. Just as good.
Y'all have anything upcoming?
Right now, my ministers every fifth Sunday, and we also, these same faithful three, they're also a part of the praise dance team where they also dance every fourth Sunday. Nothing currently upcoming as we're in our transition of moving to phase two.
Okay. So when you get together with these young ladies and y'all put together your ministry, when you get together and put it together, is there a certain format that you go by? Is it something that comes to you? Is it something that, as far as like practicing and coming together with the different choreography, how do you do that?
I kind of listen to the song. We come up with a song on what, sometimes it's based off the occasion, but a lot of times it's whatever, God lands on our spirit. Mm-hmm. And I may say, you guys decide. They'll pick a song and we'll just listen to it over and over, and then he just plants the vision. Mm-hmm. And that's how you know where it's something that God has called you to do, because he'll give it to you without a hassle.
Okay. So the songs that you choose, are those songs that, I mean, because the songs that y'all did tonight, let me see, who was that? The one that I think I liked the most was Better. Yeah, is that some song that inspired you to be able to?
A lot of the songs that were that we have been ministering in, a lot of the girls these three girls chose the songs.
Okay.
I believe, and if I'm pretty sure I'm accurate, they have taken my lifestyle and where I've come from and the things I have overcome, and they use that as motivation. So Better and I Believe, those are songs that they, surprise me with and say, we want to be a blessing to you. Mm-hmm. We want to tell you it's going to be better, or I believe you're going to make it. You've already made it. You don't look like what you've been through. So even though I lead them, they lead me most of the time too. They motivate me to want to come wake up Saturday morning and rehearse. Mm-hmm. They're my motivation for keeping my relationship with Christ.
Yeah, and it's good. I'm glad to hear you say that, because I was just about to ask you, what does that you pour into them, and then they in turn are able to minister to others. Mm-hmm. What does that do for you? What does that do for you?
I have a full-time job. Mm-hmm. I'm an author. I have a son, a household. And they just give me motivation to want to keep pushing regardless. Mm-hmm. I know I have to get up Saturday morning and rehearse with them every Saturday after working a full week, but it's the fact that I want to do it because they want to be there. They want different. I look at where I've come from and know that I don't want that for them.
Yeah.
And that's what keeps me pushing.
Yeah. Does it speak to you spiritually?
It gives me confirmation, a sense of, this is where you should have been all along. This is where I've been trying to get you to go. Everything you went through was to make you strong for this moment. Mm-hmm. So you could be strong. You have three young, beautiful young girls who are now looking up to you. Mm-hmm. sisters that I never had. I mean, I'm the youngest out of nine, so now having them three, I'm like, I'm finally the big sister. I tell you what to do. But I love it. It gives me a sense of, you know, I feel responsible for someone now. Mm-hmm. And I take that very seriously.
Yeah, and we have to take those type of things seriously because, you know, when God puts us in a position of leadership or mm-hmm. teaching,
right.
there's a heavy weight, load that comes along with that because you place yourself into a position of someone who's handling God's word.
Absolutely.
And we have to rightly divide it and rightly handle mm-hmm. it and not misuse it or abuse it in a crazy way.
Right.
And so when we take, like I always say, I always refer back to my son.
Mm-hmm.
When I have an opportunity to teach him, I'm getting him to understand that I'm not even the authority in my home.
Right.
You know,
right.
The authority in my home is God.
Absolutely.
It's his word.
Mm-hmm.
And he'll ask me, Daddy, well, why? And I will say, well, this is what the Bible says, son.
Right.
This
right.
is what God says.
Right.
Because he sees me obeying God's word.
Mm-hmm.
And then it pours into his life. You know, you're being an example mm-hmm. for these young ladies.
Right.
They see you obeying God's word.
Absolutely.
And it pours back into their life.
Mm-hmm.
Do you find sometimes that you have to pull yourself in line because mm-hmm. you know that folks are watching, that the young people have their eyes on you?
Absolutely. I mean, I'm 24 years old, mm-hmm. and, you know, especially in this day and time, you know, I still get tugged in my faith sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to remember that I have to be strong because I do have people watching me. I got to watch what, you know, I do, watch what I post, watch what I say, watch where I go.
Mm-hmm.
It's always eyes on you. But then when you realize that you've agreed to take this position
mm-hmm.
and you've stepped in this position, then you have to fulfill the duties.
Yeah.
So I've already accepted it. I can't take it back. I can't back out on God because mm-hmm. he never backed out on me. So I have to be there and complete to the end.
Yeah, and knowing and realizing that without him,
there's no me.
Yeah, without him, there's no me. Without him, there's nothing that I can accomplish. You know, I heard a song by this Christian rapper named Lecrae, and he said, I'm scared to go at it on my own because I might succeed, you know.
Yeah.
And I thought about that, how we can sometimes go on our own doing things
mm-hmm.
and do well at it
mm-hmm.
and completely think that we've left God out of it completely.
Right.
And then we start to get prideful.
Mm-hmm.
We start to feel like we can do this on our own.
Right.
But in putting God in the middle of or first in all that we do,
right.
How do you teach that to the young ladies?
I let them know that without God, nothing is impossible. When
mm-hmm.
you get weak and where you want to go, don't know, you get confused, seek him first, the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
And that's what I instill in them. Always go to him for the answers. You could come to me, but I'm only going to go to him. Cut out the middleman and get your answers straight from the source. So
that's pretty good.
Thank you.
Yeah, and teaching people how to hear God for themselves. That's
right.
That's one of the things that I always wanted to be able to do, and I always because I can steer you wrong.
Absolutely.
I am flawed.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much that I can't do and I'm not able to do.
Right.
And I don't want to do.
Right.
You know, I would rather you be following hard after God
Absolutely.
Than following after me, because if you keep your eyes on me, sooner or later you're going to see my humanity.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to see my flaws.
My mistakes.
You're going to see me fall.
Absolutely.
You're going to see me make a mistake.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want that to be something that has hindered you because I didn't teach you to follow hard after
Absolutely.
God. So here we go with Anointed Expressions one more time. And I don't look like what I've been through.
If my life had a voice and told you my journey, you wouldn't believe it. And because of his grace, there's no way you can see it. And if my scars did not heal, and if his love did God shield me, you would see that
I don't look like what I used to be. Yeah.
I don't look like what I've been through.
What I've been through.
I don't look like what I've been through.
What I've
been
through.
Thank God I survived. Now there's a smile where I've cried. There's been
such a change.
So glad I can say I can smile now.
I can smile now.
No longer mad now.
No longer mad now.
Everything's new now.
Everything's new now.
Because I went through.
Yeah,
whoa, I can smile now.
I can smile now.
No longer mad now.
No longer mad now.
Everything's new now.
Everything's new now.
All because I went through.
Because I went through.
Anointed Expressions, I don't look like what I've been through during the time that they were performing or ministering. Chainah was telling me about how you know the ladies, the young ladies, they chose that song themselves mm-hmm. and they put the dance together themselves and they did that for you.
Yeah.
Because of, you know, the things that God has brought you out of.
Right.
You know, we only got a few minutes left. You mm-hmm. want to share those couple of things that, you know, the things that God brought you, that God did for you?
Absolutely. I survived sexual assault, domestic violence. I was married before by my abuser. I got to South Carolina because I ran away from mm-hmm. being abused the whole year. Molested for years, raped at gunpoint, almost suicidal ideas, everything that they listed in the song, it was just, when I heard it, it just broke me down because mm-hmm. I was like, they've been paying attention. It was that moment that I realized how much they were watching me.
Yeah.
So, you know, I survived so much and I realized it was just for a purpose.
Mm-hmm.
I was stuck selfishly for a long time, though. Why me? Like, why did I go through this? No one's there to help me. No mother, no father, nobody.
Mm-hmm.
Why am I stuck all alone? But it was so he could build me up.
Yeah.
So I can be able to help others who feel alone.
Yeah.
They may not know it, but I know.
That's good. I know for a fact myself that God is, he is a God who will reach down into your darkest
Absolutely.
Cave. He will reach down into the depths of your pain,
mm-hmm.
and he will set you free.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So, in being set free, God gives you something out of that, doesn't he?
Yes. I thought that my voice was taken because I couldn't talk about what I went through for so long and mm-hmm. didn't know how to even express it because I was already torn so far apart. So, you know, starting this mime ministry and doing these things, it just helped me be able to let people know without a voice, you mm-hmm. can still speak.
That's right. We're about to close a great evening. WGGS has had an awesome night. If you have a situation, anything that you're dealing with yourself,
mm-hmm.
just call out to God.
Absolutely.
Take this opportunity to call out to God.
Yes.
And I promise you, he will be the one that will deliver you. Thank you. Have a great evening.